Paradise Congregate is a 6-bed facility that we can take care of very sick people from subacute, that means they're on a ventilator with G-tube, they can be paralyzed, hemiplegic, paraplegic, quadriplegic patients, or just either on the ventilator or just with a trach care. And we can also provide acute and subacute rehab for the patients for several weeks to several months if we get usually get agreement with the insurance company to pay for it. Where physical therapy, occupational therapy, speech therapy come to our small 6-bed house and provides that care. But instead of being in the nursing facility with 100 people in there, we have 6 people and looks like a house, a 24-hour nurse, LVN and CNA, which is certified nursing aide. They're dispensing medication, taking care of the trach. We have RRT, which is a respiratory therapist, taking care of their ventilator and trach care. We have pulmonologists and, of course, doctor all the time on call to take care of the patients. Ratio is a huge thing in congregate facility. In Paradise Congregate Facility, we have one CNA for 6 people, where in any nursing home, it's usually 1 to 20 or sometimes even more. And there is no way they can clean the patient. You know, 20 patients in a week time. So the quality of care definitely will be decreased. Or giving medications, correct dose, right medications to every single patient. That's a big responsibility for LVN, and being overwhelmed with so many charts and so many medications is not a good thing most of the time, especially if patients requesting as needed medications, it's even harder on them because it's not scheduled and they asking for pain, but she's taking care of 10 other patients. By the time she gives the medications, they're 2 hours in pain. Being in a home-like environment with 6 patients, it's a big difference versus being in the subacute like rehab or in a hospital. Very helpful for the patients to live like in a normal house. When you drive by any congregate facility, you don't see any difference. It doesn't look like commercial building or, you know, like big parking lot or anything. It's a normal residential house. And when you step in, it's like a living room. And then in the rooms, there are patients living their lives. So it's basically a very nice way of providing medical care without feeling that you're like these patients are in a hospital or in a nursing home. For congregate care, we accept most of the insurances. Medicare is not covering our stay in congregate care because Medicare only covers 100 days in rehabilitation in rehab facilities. And after that, it kicks into the secondary insurances anyways. So we accept a letter of agreement or contracts with any insurances, which is PPO, HMO insurance. From Medi-Cal, the only difference is we do accept Medi-Cal, but it has to be applied for Medi-Cal waiver. And after it's approved, which for the most people it's approved, then it's paid by Medi-Cal. I have a friend who asked me to be involved because he needed a partner who would be a physician and be in a medical field and, you know, just help him to involve, but he would be on a more, technical side. He knows how to find the the house and rebuild it by the code and get applications ready. So after that was all done, basically, I just transitioned to a role of providing care of the patients. There is a big need in congregate care facilities, like Paradise Congregate Facility, because there is a shortage in the nursing homes in general. There is aging population, of course, all over the country. And with that, providing care in congregate facility, it's more personalized. It's a nicer environment. It's lower ratio to the from nurses to the patients, and it's basically personalized care of the patient.